In this tech update, we'll talk about student-teacher models, an intriguing new way of training your AI models. I'll tell you what student-teacher models are, how to get it set up, and I'll give you two applications. The student-teacher setup is a way of training artificial intelligence models. Artificial intelligence, in short AI, is the science of letting a computer create things or make decisions based on a lot of data instead of giving it predefined man-made rules. The aim of student-teacher models is to have a teacher, a highly complex AI model that can perform a certain task, teach its task to the student, a less complex AI model with less computational power needed. There's three reasons why you could need a teacher-student method. The first one is the lack of the right data set. The second one is that the original model is too complex and costs too much computational power to run. And the third one is if you would want to switch the source, the input that the models get, to another type of source. For example, from imagery to 3D points. So, how to set up this student-teacher model. There are four things you need to do in order to get the student-teacher setup running. The first one is to get your highly complex but really accurate AI model, the teacher, for the task that you need to execute. The second step is to get your student, your own more simple AI model with which you want to get the job done later on. The third step is to give them both the same or very similar inputs and let them execute their models. Step four, assess the output of both the student and the teacher models. In this case, the teacher will always be right and the student needs to adapt its inner calculations in order to get the same answer as the teacher next time. Now you repeat step three and four indefinitely until the student does not improve anymore or when you're satisfied with the result. You can now throw away the teacher model and only start using the student. So, that is how you set up student-teacher models, but let's see what you can do with it in the real world. Application 1. Embedded computer vision. In some scenarios, you want to have accurate AI models that use very little power. In this case, on the savannas on Africa, AI models are being used to track animals in order to keep them out of the hands of poachers. This is done by placing small cameras on very remote locations throughout the savanna. You can imagine, in those remote locations, you only have, for example, solar power, which means you can't put up a huge computer there. Also, because it's so remote, there's a very limited internet access, so it's not feasible to stream the camera output to the cloud and compute the AI models there. So we have a need for those accurate AI models in those remote locations. Using the student-teacher model, we can first pick our highly complex teacher model that is super good at tracking animals and teach it to the student model that is way less complex, uses less power, and can be deployed on the cameras themselves. In this way, we don't have to stream the entire camera output, but we can only send a message once we've detected an animal. What if you want to detect whether there are still people inside your office during an emergency? For example, when the fire alarm goes off, you'd want to know whether there's anyone inside, also in the toilets. However, if we were to set up cameras throughout our entire office, also in the toilets, to detect people, it would be hugely disrupting their privacy. So we might have to look at other options than cameras. For example, heat sensors or 3D sensors. The problem is that for cameras, there is already very accurate AI models made by larger tech companies that are super sophisticated. For heat sensing or 3D sensing, there is no AI model yet. However, with the student-teacher setup, we can use the camera system as the teacher while we use the heat or 3D sensing system as a student. So in a trial period, we could hang up cameras and other sensors throughout the office for a certain amount of time. The camera would then detect the true output, whether there are people in that room. And the 3D or heat sensors would learn how to interpret their own data in order to detect those very same people as well. In the process, they will get slowly better and better at detecting it from their own data until the point they don't improve anymore or we're satisfied. And then we can throw away that privacy disrupting camera system and only keep the sensors that we want, the heat or 3D sensors, and start using that for our application. So to sum it up, student-teacher models can help you out if you don't have the right data, you already have a model, but you wanted to use less computational power, or when you do want to do a similar task, but with a different data source. Thanks for watching the Tech Update by BIT on student-teacher models, and I hope to see you in the next one.